if you will allow him to do that tonight and be spiritual with this message. Amen. Amen. We in a day and age. Sister Shelley, I'm excited what God's doing in your life. Amen. Amen. It took a long time to get that fire started. Maybe a long time. Maybe it was just coals there. But the right wind came along and started the fire. Amen. Ain't
come
God
on,
good?
Come on. Come on.
Ain't God good?
Amen.
Amen. And you just keep continuously throwing wood on it. Amen. You got to keep it hot. Amen.
Yeah.
And if you keep it hot, people will come up and want to warm by it.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
I'm telling you something you can cook on.
Yeah.
That's right. Amen. You can get purified by it. Amen. If it's the right heat. That's just what my God is. But tonight, amen, let's look at verse 9 and 10. I'll read these and we're going to pray and let God be God in this place. It says, "And I shall say unto you, ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asks, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened." And tonight, are you a seeker? Tonight, church, are you a seeker? Lord, as we come before you tonight, Jesus. Lord, there is none like you. Lord God, I just give you thanks today, Lord.
Yes.
I give you praise tonight, God, for this message. Lord, I want to thank you, Lord God, that we come into this place and begin to lift your name up, Lord God. And somehow, some way, Lord God, you stop your busy schedule and come in here and rest in this place with us. That we can feel your presence so mighty, Lord God. And Lord God, we don't take it for granted, Jesus. But Lord, it's an honor for you to be in here with us. Lord, that we can feel you and know that we've been favored by you one more time. And Lord God, I just ask tonight, God, is this wisdom that you've given me, this word, Lord God, right out of your mouth, Lord Jesus, I pray, God, that I do it justice, Lord. Lord God, I pray tonight you would allow this flesh, Lord God, to be removed, Lord God. And let me totally hear your voice, Lord God, as I preach, Lord God, to your great people, Lord God. I thank you tonight, Jesus, for the Holy Ghost. Lord, I thank you for the comforting spirit, Lord. Lord, I thank you for the love and mercy that you've shown, Lord. And most of all, Lord God, I thank you for the blood, Lord Jesus, that you shed for us, Lord God, that we would have life and have it more abundant, Lord. I thank you so much. I thank you so much, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, in the name of Jesus. Ain't God good? You can be seated if you can. I'm sure I'll preach and not teach. But let me give you the definition of seek real quick. Because I feel like we're going to get started and not slow down. Amen. But the definition of seek is this. And pay close attention to it. It's to search out. Are you a seeker tonight? To find what you're looking for. To search out. Amen. Are you looking? Amen. Have you found what you've been looking for? Amen. Ain't God good?
Amen.
Oh, Holy Ghost, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. I want to start in the book of the Old Testament, if you would allow me. Amen. If you want to go to Leviticus chapter 19. Amen. I've got a few places I want to read tonight to you. Amen. And just let God be God in this place.
Amen.
Because you can give people these scriptures. Amen. I know I preach to you, and I know my sister Kelly says that she prays sometimes that the Lord would reveal it to her like he reveals it to me. But I'm telling you, sometimes I feel mighty low up here sometimes that y'all should be preaching to me and me out there receiving, amen, because God has blessed you with gifts and blessed you with knowledge, amen. But look at verse in Leviticus chapter 19, look at verse 31, amen. Some people are looking for the wrong thing, amen. He said, "Regard not them that have familiar spirits, neither seek after wizards to be defiled by them. I am your Lord, excuse me, I am the Lord your God, amen." Amen. And that's what we're kind of getting at tonight in this. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm not seeking out the world. Amen. For hope. I'm not seeking out the world. Amen. For wealth. Amen. I'm not seeking out the world tonight for an answer. I know where my answer lies, church.
Amen.
It's in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm not going to let some man direct me. Amen. And direct my path. I'm going to call on Him, the One, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the author.
Amen.
Amen. And the finisher of our faith.
Amen.
I'm just building a foundation because I really want to take you tonight to the deep. Amen. If you'll go to the book of Numbers with me, chapter 15. Amen. I want to do some sharing with you. Amen. I want to make sure that we blood bought. Amen. I really want to make sure tonight, amen, you seek it after the real deal. Amen. And I'm not talking, amen, about old Holyfield. Amen. I'm talking about the real deal. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. Amen. I really want to know, is your heart, amen, desiring to see Him? Amen. And does your heart ache, amen, when you don't feel Him and you don't hear His voice? Amen. Do you get them butterflies in your stomach and say something's wrong? I have not heard from my master today. I've not got my visitation. Something must be wrong. Amen. I must have been done. Amen. Something, amen, to offend Him. Amen. But I want you to look at verse 38. Amen. And I'll set this up after I read it. Or maybe I ought to do it now. Amen. That we know that the Old Testament, amen, that Moses wrote the first five books. Amen. And we know that Moses, if you go back and study any in the Hebrew history at all, amen, and I had an opportunity to just study that for a while. Amen. Especially when Obama come into office, I really got my nose, amen, amen, into this word, amen, and tried to make sure that this church, amen, would not be led astray. But there were 612 laws, amen, brought, amen, that Moses pinned down, amen, for Israel to hold on to. And this was one of their laws, amen, that they had to hold to. Amen. And I want y'all to see it. It was a custom, Sister Shelley, amen. And I want to read it, amen, because it ought to be a stake in your and my heart today, amen. It says to speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations. Plural. Do y'all see that? And that they put upon the fringe, upon the borders of their riband of blue. Amen. It had to be a certain color. It had to be fringes, Brother Bo. I want y'all to make note of what, amen, that Moses, amen, is commanding the children of Israel to do for what the Lord said they had to do. And it shall be unto them a fringe that you may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord and do them. And that you should seek not after your own heart and your own eyes, after which you used to go a-whoring, it says, that you may remember and do all my commandments and be holy unto your God. I am the Lord God which brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am the Lord your God. Amen. And I don't know about what y'all read when y'all read that. Amen. And I know that church folks, amen, get that mixed up today because they say we have to, amen, to look a certain way to be holy. But let me tell y'all this. I want to bring something that what the Lord brought to my mind. Amen. If we've got to wear a certain attire, amen, to have reminded of who we serve, church, we in trouble. Amen. I can take Sister Jennifer. She's my wife. Amen. And I'm going to pick on her. Amen. If I have to remind Sister Jennifer that she's married to me, we in trouble. Amen. If I have to remind her, amen, that she's a mama, amen, and a mother, amen, we in trouble, church. If I have to remind her that she's the mother of this church, amen, when she leaves our house, amen, the church is in trouble. Can I get an amen? It ain't going to be what you put on. Amen. It's going to be the desire that's in your heart. Amen. Not the sin. against your God. David said this, amen, let the word be hidden in my heart that I might not sin, amen, against you. And I don't know what if you can understand that. It wasn't a mark 666 across the head. Amen. It's not a tattoo of Jesus Christ on the bicep to remind of the crucifixion, church. But David asked, amen, that it be where the soul is. Amen. That it would be to the place of the nervous system. Amen. To where he would react from. The way he would do business. The way that he would worship. The way that he would think tonight, church. I believe, amen, with all my heart tonight. Amen. That when, if we're going to be a seeker, amen, God should not have to remind us that we Christian folk. God should have to remind this preacher to get on his knees. God shouldn't have to remind me to fast. He shouldn't have to remind me to read the word. Amen. He should not remind me, Sister Shelley, amen, to lift your name up in prayer. He should not have to condemn me of my walk, church, if I love him. Can I get an amen in this tonight, church? Amen. It's not going to be on the outside, my God, but it's going to be what is being put inside of us. Amen. It's what's been planted. In church, my God, in the name of Jesus. But I want to take you real quick to the Songs of Solomon, amen, if you're willing to go there. Oh, hallelujah. My God, I would hate to know, amen, that I would have to walk around, Sister Shelley, with a white shirt on, amen, that everybody would recognize me as a preacher, amen, as a pastor, amen. I was in a parts store. And I told a fella I was greasy from one head to the one from the top to the head or soles of my feet because I was working on one of them trucks. And I was polite when I walked into a fella and he come over and wanted to talk to me. That's the first thing he wanted to tell me is how he was a pastor somewhere else. Amen. And I just, Brother Bo, I didn't look like no preacher. Because I had the ball cap on and I had grease, I had it everywhere. That's why I hate mechanicing, because I get more on me than I do trying to work on what I'm working on, amen. But I listened to what he had to say, amen. But I want y'all to understand something, amen. I believe it's the Spirit that's going to draw, because that's what the Word says. I just believe that, and maybe I'm the wrong one in this, amen. But I need y'all to see this and understand, because God wants to do something, amen. God wants, amen, a people that's going to run after him, that's going to be sold out.
Amen.
And I was just thinking of some things today, amen, how God works and how he does things. Amen. I begin to pray for my brother-in-law, amen, and I would text Kelly and I'd say, how is he? Amen. This morning, that's what I texted her, and she said, he's not doing good at all. Amen. But I begin, amen, to lift his name up as I was running that weed eater first thing this morning. I run that weed eater, Sister Shelley, and I was praying for Wilbur Simmons, amen. And I put a backpack sprayer on, and I was spraying an area that we got to lay saw at, amen. And I just felt good in my spirit, Sister Crystal. And I texted her back, and I said, how is he now, amen? Hallelujah. She said, you ain't going to believe it, but he's better, amen. But I said, well, it ain't over, because I'm claiming complete healing, amen.
Yeah.
I believe that I serve a God, and I put it in bold letters, amen. He said that I could ask and receive.
Yeah.
I read it to you at the beginning of the sermon, church, because you can knock and receive. Amen. You can seek and find in this. That's what's so unique about Jesus. If you'll just trail him a little bit, Brother Bo, amen, you'll run into him. But look at what Songs of Solomon had wrote here. I want you to listen to this poetry real close, Sister Carrie. It said, by night on my bed I sought him whom my soul loveth. Talking about the soul tonight, church. I sought him, but I found him not. I will rise now and go about the city and the streets. And in the broad ways I will seek him whom my soul loveth. I sought him, but I found him not. Amen. Everybody see that? Some people would quit right then. I was talking to a fella yesterday, amen. And he was telling me, he said, I know God, you can speak his name and he can deliver right now.
Right.
And I said, that is true.
That's right.
And he said, I've seen him do it. But he said, I'm in dire straits of something and I just don't understand why he don't produce right now. I said, well, you're going to have to understand he's God and he does what he wants to. Amen. And you got to trust in him. What I know about him, that he's a just and true God. And I also know if you aggravate him, because we're made in his own image, by the way. And what happens to us when we get aggravated? Somehow we get further and further away from the problem, amen, or the answer, or the equation, amen. Somehow we put a monkey wrench in it. But if you let God be God, amen, but let me go on. Amen. I got somewhere I want to get you to tonight. Amen. But it says, for the watchman that knoweth about the city, or goeth about the city, found me, to whom I said, saw ye him whom my soul loveth, amen. This person is searching out, trying to find the one, amen. I know this is Old Testament, but you're going to have to look at this, amen, in a spiritual setting tonight, amen. Amen, because he's still or she's still, well, don't matter what the sex is, they're looking for the emptiness. They're looking for something of what their soul, amen, is seeking tonight.
Wow.
And it said, and it was but a little that I passed from them, but I found him whom my soul loveth. And I held him, it says, and I would not let him go until I brought him, amen, into my mother's house, into the chambers of her that conceived me. Amen. And you need to look at this in a place, amen, that was brought. Sister Karen, amen, just like Sister Crystal talked about her prayer closet that she went into this morning. Amen. That is a secret place, amen, that you should have in a place that you want to abide with your King, amen, with Jesus. They ought to be a private place, amen, that you want to get in there, amen, and begin to commune and begin to worship, begin to talk, church. Amen. And this is what Solomon is beginning to describe. Amen. This person has found what it was longing for. Amen. And I said at the beginning of this service, are you a seeker? Amen. Are you really going to set out, amen, to find this Jesus? Amen. And find out what he's all about.
Amen.
All right. I know y'all probably looking at me crazy and saying, Brother Kenny, we already know this. Amen. But somebody needs this. Or God would have not have given it to me.
Come on.
Amen.
Come
to Genesis. Amen. You're going to run on your path. Amen. It's going to cross. Amen. If we have a desire for him, we're going to be looking for him.
Come on.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Let's go to Genesis chapter 37. I know I'm all about this Bible tonight, but there's something right here. Amen. That ought to be another eye-opener for you and I in Genesis 37. Amen. If we truly love this Jesus, if we truly have the Holy Ghost, Sister Shelley, inside of us, amen, I believe it ought to burn and turn inside of us. Amen. Something Jesus always had said. Amen. And I know it mixes up the Trinity people and they get warp-minded when he said this. He said, I must be about my Father's business. Amen. And I'm here to tell you tonight, I must be about Jesus' business. Amen. I must walk a holy and righteous life before him. Amen. That the Bible tells me that I'll have to give account to every idle word that I say. Amen. And I'm here to tell you tonight, we ought to watch what we should say. It ain't got to be a cigarette. It ain't got to be a can of beer. It ain't got to be marijuana crack that'll send you to hell. Church, it can be an idle word that you have said. Because the Bible said this, Jesus said it, except your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the Pharisees, you shall no wise enter in, church. And I believe that them people had a walk they thought was the right walk. Amen. But if we could get in the right mindset, amen, offend him, amen, with what we do, church, it ought to scare us to offend our God tonight.
Amen.
But here's another spiritual thing that I want you to get a hold of. In 37, if you want to catch it around the 13th verse, I think. Right? 15th verse. 13:15. You got a type and shadow right here. Israel's fixing to send Joseph out. And here's a question that's been asked. Israel asks Joseph, says, ain't your brethren, ain't they in Shushan? Is that where they at feeding the flock? And will you go? And Joseph says, I'm paraphrasing in the scripture because I want to get you to 15. And Joseph says, here I am, I'll go. Everybody see that?
Amen.
But let's pick it up in verse 15. Because there's a lot of good information right here that I want you to have tonight on a spiritual note. It says, and a certain man found him, talking about Joseph. He found Joseph. Behold, he was wandering in the field. And the man asked him, saying, what seekest thou? And he said, I seek my brethren. Tell me, I pray thee, where they feed their flock. You ready, church?
Mm-hmm.
The word certain means this, because it said in a certain man. The word certain means this, to know for sure, established beyond doubt. Let me say it again. Know for sure, established beyond doubt is what that word certain means. So let me read this for you. Because I want you to get a hold of it. There's an angel sitting over there. A certain man found him. Amen. Somebody that the Lord sent.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Joseph is wandering around. Amen. Trying to find his brother that's feeding the sheep, feeding the flock. Amen. If we could get a hold of this tonight. Amen. We ought to be the certain. Amen. Men and women of God. Amen. Without, we ought to be established, Sister Karen, without a doubt. Amen. We ought to know who our King is. We ought to know who we serve. Amen. He ought to be able to depend on you and I tonight. Amen. Giving us thus saith the Lord. Amen. If we could just open our spiritual eye tonight, Brother Bowen, and see, amen, there's many Josephs out there wandering around, wondering, amen, where is the word being preached? Amen. Where is the flock being fed at? Amen. Where is this place, amen, that I need to be that I can get a hold? Because, see, people are searching, amen, and they looking, and they wondering, amen. And if you'll go on and read a little bit further in verse 17, you'll find out that that old prophet or the angel or whatever that certain man was, give him the direction of where he needed to go. And telling you something tonight, if we love this Jesus, and if we seeking him with everything that we got tonight, church, amen, if we the blood bought, my God, if we the ones, we ought to be, Sister Karen, the certain ones, amen, looking, amen, be looking in the field, looking at them wandering around, making a way and an opportunity, amen, and ask, what are you looking for? Amen, what are you looking for? Amen, what Jesus asked the woman, what are you seeking, when she came to the well. Amen. The woman thought she was coming from water, but Jesus knew there was something else that had been pondered in that woman's head for a long time. Amen. She knew she wasn't living right. My God, she knew that she was in a rut. Amen. But Jesus came by. My God, there's people today wandering around. Amen. Do I got everything that I need? Some people ain't reading John 5:39, where it says, search the scriptures, for in them you think you have salvation. Amen. Eternal life. Amen. They some is just wandering around, wondering where the revival's at, wondering where I can get something, where I can get fed tonight. In church, we're supposed to have the answer. Amen. If we love this King, if we love this Messiah, amen, if we blood bought, all, church. Amen. If we really seek in His will tonight, amen, we'll be that certain person. Know for sure, thus saith the Lord. Can't be persuaded. Sister Shelley, that's one thing I can say about you that's aggravated me for the last couple of years. That I know that you could not be persuaded into what you believed. But just to get you to say it, stand on it.
Amen.
I love you. And I'm glad what you're doing now. To get that boldness out. I knew you was there the whole time because I knew you couldn't be wavered. But get you to speak it because you that certain man, you that certain woman that knows without a shadow of a doubt, amen, that God wrote Himself in flesh and dwelt among men. My God, in the name of Jesus, and went into His own, and His own received Him not. My God, but I'm telling you, when He gave me His name, I went into Him, church.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. I can't be persuaded, amen, the oneness of the Godhead. You will never take me from that. I may never preach in front of 10,000. I may never have a church that's running 25,000. Amen, like some's got. But one thing that I will know, amen, that I assure you, you will never persuade me from the truth. I know the day of judgment. Slain, my God, for the sin in this world. And I know His name is Jesus. I know it's from the tribe of He's the Lion of the tribe of Judah, church.
Hallelujah.
Oh, mighty God. Hallelujah, church. That's where we at tonight. I don't know if you can take this, if you want it or not, but the word certain is 231 times in the Bible. Amen. 93 in the old, 138 in the new. Something that caught my eyes. I was just looking some of this up. Amen. The word certain is 44 times in the book of Luke. And the book of Acts is 59 times. That's the highest number, amen, is in the book of Acts. And let me read the definition again. To know for sure, established beyond doubt, Peter, James, and John, and the Apostle Paul, they knew without a doubt, amen, what they was preaching. They knew without a doubt about this Holy Ghost. They were established in it because Jesus looked at Peter and said, Peter, Satan desires to sift you as wheat, but I have prayed for you that when thou art converted, that you will go and strengthen the brethren. Amen. He was established without a doubt, church. Philip was established without a doubt.
Yes.
Stephen was established without a doubt. Certain, church. I'm certain we're on the right path.
Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying? I'm certain that we've got the truth. Amen. And the Bible tells me when Jesus stood up and said that He was the bread of life. Amen. The Bible said that many of His disciples walked away and never came back. Amen. So I'm over surprised that the church house is not filled. Oh, I believe like my mother believes. Amen. With tribulation, when it gets hot. Amen. They're going to be like they were around Jesus. But Jesus has shot him. He hit him with a sledgehammer between the eyes when He said, you don't seek me for who I am. You are seeking me because you ain't of the fishes and the loaves. You cannot explain the miracles, but you did partake of it. I'm telling you right now, when it gets bad, Sister Shelley, you ain't going to have to coerce them to come in. They're going to be stacking here like cordwood. We ain't going to be able to get in here. But they're going to be wanting fishes and loaves. They're not going to want what you and I got. My God, they don't want Psalms of Solomon. They ain't out here searching. Amen, because their soul is empty. Amen, but church, I'm here to tell you what it says in Genesis. I believe, Sister Crystal, there's a few out there that's wandering around in a pasture, amen. Amen, trying to find, amen, where the flock is being fed.
Amen, that's right. Praise God.
And it's time to make ourselves available.
Amen. Yes.
The give direction.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Go this way.
Right.
This is thus saith the Lord.
All right.
See, they coming by, sister, because they hungry.
Yes.
Think about it.
Right.
Well, see, that's what Israel told Joseph. They supposed to be feeding my sheep. They got to be somewhere out there.
Right.
And Joseph is wandering around. See, they're commissioned to go out.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They're Mormon. They're commissioned to go out.
Right.
Well, see, they found a place they can get warm.
Right.
They found a place that where their hunger pains all of a sudden being curb appetite.
Mm-hmm.
Getting something. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
You got to get on a spiritual level.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And you take a restaurant, whether it be high dollar or not, if it don't serve good food, you don't go back.
That's right.
But if it's good food, you'll go stand in the line.
Amen.
They're coming back walking because it's good food.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. That's the third, fourth time now. It's good food. They keep coming back. It's a good place to eat.
Right.
Y'all making sense? They wandering.
Right.
You got to be that certain woman to give directions. It's getting fed over here.
All right.
Think about what I'm saying. But you remember what Jesus, we have to go back to the book of John. I ain't going to preach long, church. I'm going to just give you what God wants you to have.
Amen.
But just so you know this, I know if you like information, knowledge is power, I believe it.
Amen.
You got to go back to the book of John. But anyway, it's 291 times the word seek is in the Bible. 210 times in the Old and 81 in the New. I think these things are irrelevant to know. That word, if it's been plastered that many times, there's a purpose behind it.
Come on.
To seek and find out, you need to search. You know, we sing that song, searching till I found him.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? We gotta tell people's looking. People want this, but see, this is Jesus. I like the way Jesus speaks because it's simple.
Yes.
Ain't hard to understand. It's just Jesus. And Jesus said in John chapter 1, verse 38, I know y'all never read this scripture, that's why I got it wrote down where I can read it to you. It says this. Because, see, John the Baptist has done told them, there he is. That's the one you're looking for. And then Jesus turned and saw them following and said unto them, what seekest ye? They said unto him, Rabbi, which is interpreted Master, where dwellest thou? What a question to ask. How many of us ever asked, Lord, where are you living? I want to come visit. But see, we know in the New Testament he's supposed to be in him. Where are you dwelling? My God, I hope people see the Holy Ghost. I hope, Sister Karen, they see Jesus. I hope they know that the Lord dwells here in me. Amen. Do you hear what I'm saying tonight,
Amen.
Church?
Amen.
Oh, mighty God, almighty God, almighty God, almighty God. That's the God that we serve tonight. Amen. What are you seeking? Amen. They were seeking. Amen. Those two disciples, Sister Karen was looking for something. And John directed them. See, that certain one directed them. This is the one I was telling you about that I'm not worthy. Amen. To tie his shoes.
Wow.
This is the one I said would come after me. Amen. Wow. That I was before him. Amen. Making him a wage. Amen. Y'all listen to me. Amen. They were seeking. Amen. And Jesus asked, what you looking for? And they wanted to know. Amen. And I believe that tonight. Sister Shelley, I'm going to be praying. Amen. That they come home. Amen. Because they're looking. And they're seeking for something. Amen. Amen. I'm telling you something. If they were getting fed. Amen, Sister Shelley, I believe this with all my heart. A fellow that's full, if he's full, amen, it don't matter how Sister Crystal makes him collard greens and hog jowl, it don't matter. If that man's full, he ain't going to eat. Come on, somebody. Amen, and them people are not full or they wouldn't be coming around. Amen, because they have tasted something, amen, they have never ate before. And it's good to them. Amen. And that's what David said, come and taste and see if the Lord is not good.
Come on.
Come on and taste this. Amen. Come get you some of this Holy Ghost. Come stand in His presence. Amen. And let the fullness of the Godhead, amen, be revealed that you can live. Because Jesus said this, I come to give you life and come to give it to you more abundant. And you can't have it more abundant if you don't have revelation. If you don't know that you don't have freedom to worship. If you don't know that you can walk among your enemy and know that your enemy cannot touch you. My God, just like what we read in Songs of Solomon, amen, that you will turn the world off. Amen, seeking after His face. Amen, the world can blow up. The world can just be an atomic bomb can hit it. Nuclear warfare can happen. Amen. But that one closet you in will still be standing there as you praise and worship. And you can come out and you wouldn't have to wear one of them suits because you'd be full of the Holy Ghost, church. Let's stand tonight. My God, are you a seeker? Are you willing to go find? Are you certain? Are you established without a shadow of a doubt? Paul said, I'm persuaded. And I can't quote that scripture all the way, but he said, I'm persuaded. Nothing can hurt us. I'm going to paraphrase it because I can't get it out right. I just lost it. Huh? I'm persuaded that I cannot be separated from my King. I will not sin against Him. Bro, I try to pray that prayer every morning if I don't pray nothing else. Lord, don't let me sin against you. Don't let nothing get in between you and I that I can't feel you. I can't reach you. Amen. Take everything. And I'm going to scare my wife to death. I know she's in here. I said, take it all from me. But don't let nothing get between you and I. Don't let nothing get between you and I. Put me in a cardboard box. It'll be fine. I'll eat some potted meat. Amen. But don't let nothing get between me and you. Don't let me sin. You watch me. Amen. And you chastise me. You correct me. You thump me on the head. You do whatever it takes, amen, to keep me focused on your kingdom. Amen. But don't let me sin against you. Don't let me sin against you. I want to be a secret church. My God. I want to seek Him out. Brother Bo, when I open my closet door and on that right hand side all them suits is there, I don't want Sister Shelley that to be the only time that's reminding me that I'm a preacher. I want to know 24/7 that I can call on Him, that I reverence Him. If I do decide to take my wife to Dairy Queen out to eat, I want to be in a place, Sister Crystal, and if somebody needs prayer, that my life is in order, that I can lay hands on them. The necktie ain't going to make it, church. The old sunshiny shoes won't make it. The old white shirt ain't going to bring the Holy Ghost across. It's what's inside. Come on, somebody, you might as well get real in this thing. Sister Crystal said we needed to worship tonight. I am so thankful. Sister Shelley, there is a Chinese elm tree, I believe it is. It's a Chinese tungle tree. That's what it is. I went to a guy's house, and I've been seeing them here lately. But they grow 16 foot a year. 16 foot. And Sister Jennifer, you know what tree I'm talking about. When we lived on Pine Avenue there, we run that tree over and that tree would grow. Isn't there about like Jack and the Beanstalk? It would nearby grow overnight again. And I finally found out what, because a guy grows these things. And sister, that's just like you grow 16 foot. Just boom. Awesome. Can't stop me now. I'm growing. I'm established. I'm certain. Without a doubt, I know what my calling is. I know the Lord's going to see me through.
Yes.
Think about what I'm saying tonight. This God that we serve is so awesome. This God that we serve is so awesome. Oh, hallelujah, mighty God, Jesus. I'm not going to run after a wizard. I don't mind saying this, my brother, that I'm close to now. I had to precaution him about something. We got talking about Saul and the witch of Endor. I said, there's something that I want you to see in this. I said, it's true that she was a witch. But I said, he went to the flesh for an answer. He was looking for man for the answer when he's God's anointed. Think about what I'm saying. I said, be careful of who you're trying to get an answer from. Because we only serve one. The Bible said, let every man be a liar, but let God be true. Let no man deceive you. Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, in the name of Jesus. May be good just to make an altar where you're at and just begin to worship. I've given you what God wanted you to have. I've done everything that He's asked me to do. If you want prayer, we'll pray. I wish you would remember Sister Kelly. She is in the biggest spiritual warfare I've ever seen. The Bible tells me where two are touching one thing in agreement that it shall come to pass. And I refuse to see my sister lose that battle. Oh, mighty God, Jesus. Hallelujah. There's something big fixing to happen in Ponce de Leon, Florida. Because, see, all she never cried to the Lord and say, Lord, where you at? She and Sister Karen, that ain't what she cries at. She says, Lord, if I've got to endure this tribulation, give me some souls for it. Give me some souls for it. If I've got to endure tribulation, give me souls. That's her cry to her King. My God, what an attitude to have. Oh, hallelujah, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. I believe she's one of the certain ones that cannot be persuaded. Oh, mighty God, Jesus. Lord, I just praise you tonight. Lord, you are mighty. You are mighty, you are mighty, you are mighty, you are mighty, Jesus. For there is none like you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Jesus, for the blood tonight. Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. Lord, I ask you tonight, Jesus. Lord, you know all things. Lord, you are mighty. Mighty strong tower, Jesus. There is none like you, Lord. And Lord God, whatever this need may be, Lord God, I don't even want to know it. I want him to know that you are a miracle working God and you are concerned. Lord, you said if you knew that the sparrow fall to the ground, and the raven did not have to worry about where it was going to get its food, for surely you would supply our needs. You would be worried about us. And I ask you right now, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, Jesus. Lord, I praise you, God. Oh, hallelujah. Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, in the name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, these are yours, Jesus. Lord God, this is your people, Lord God. Your great people up here, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, Lord Jesus. Lord, I ask you tonight to equip. Lord God, I ask you tonight, God, to stir like you've never stirred before, Lord God. But Lord God, move in such a mighty way, God, in our lives, Lord. Lord, let they look with a spiritual eye, Lord Jesus. Lord, let them take the blinders off, God. Let the scale fall from their eyes, God. And they'll be able to see them that's wandering around, Lord God, wanting to be fed tonight. Looking for where their brethren is, where it's being fed, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, Jesus, I praise you. Lord, I praise you, I praise you, I praise you, Jesus. Oh, God, you were mighty, Lord, you were mighty, you were mighty, you were mighty, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. This worship church. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, God, I just ask you, Lord God, to move from Chloe, Lord God, and her family. Oh, God, I pray right now, Lord, let her come draw more and more. Jesus, I pray, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah, Lord God, I pray in your name, Jesus. Lord, let the fruit come from the labor, Lord God, I pray, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, I pray tonight, Jesus. Lord, equip us, Jesus. Equip, 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 Lord. Stir, stir, stir us, Lord God, that we will have the mindset of you. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, Jesus. 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 Oh, God. Orthodox Jew walk up to that wailing wall and begin to bob up and down trying to pray because they looking, Brother Bo, for him to come the first time. Still looking, amen. Still in bondage. Still in bondage. Oh, mighty God, Jesus. I'm so glad I found him. Oh, hallelujah. I am so glad I found him. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, Jesus. Lord, I praise you, Jesus. Mighty God, Jesus.
has never been stirred before, Jesus. Lord God, I pray right now that you turn him inside out, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, oh, mighty God, oh, mighty God, oh, mighty God. Oh, Jesus, let him be a true seeker. Oh, mighty God, let him be a true seeker in you, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, I pray, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, Jesus. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, Jesus. Lord, I praise you, Jesus. Oh, there is none like you, God. There is none like you, Jesus. Oh, mighty God.